dear students, welcome to DAV Vishnu Vidyaniketan's online classes. Today we are going to discuss about reflection of light at curved surfaces from 10th class physical science. So let us go with the terminology. Reflection of light. What is reflection of light? The process of sending back light rays when they fall on a surface of an object is called reflection of light. Simply, a bouncing back of light rays when they incident on any surface is called reflection of light. So let us see a surface and a black color dotted line, which is the normal to the surface, means perpendicular to the surface. So these are the rays coming from the object or source. These are called incident rays. As they are incident on the surface, they are called as incident rays, and they will get bounced back, and these are called reflected rays. And this entire process or phenomena is called as reflection of light. Now, example, silver metal is one of the best reflectors of light. That's why it is used in the preparation of mirrors. And mirrors we use on our dressing tables in our home are plane mirrors. A light ray is a straight line along which the light travel, and the bundle of rays is called beam of light. If it is a single light ray, then we can consider only one. And if there are more than one parallel rays are there, then they are called as beam of loss of reflection. The angle of incidence is equal to the angle of reflection. That is, angle I is the angle of incidence, angle R is the angle of reflection. Let us see, this is the surface and this is the normal. And when a light ray comes and incident on the surface, that is called incident ray, and it will get bounced back or reflected in the another direction. Now the angle between the incident ray and the normal is called as angle of incidence, I. The angle between normal and reflected ray is called as angle of reflection, R. And here angle of incidence is always equals to angle of reflection. That is the first law of reflection. And second law, the incident ray, the reflected ray and the normal to the mirror at the point of incidence all lie in the same plane. This is called second law of reflection. And these laws are applicable to all types of reflecting surfaces, whether they are plane, whether they are curved, whatever it may be. These are all applicable to all types of surfaces. Now, what is image? What is an image? An image is formed when the light rays coming from the object and meet at a point after reflection. Condition is after reflection from a mirror is called an image. So after reflection, if the two rays are met, then that is called as image. So that is the image. Now there are two types of images, real image and virtual image. There are two types of images, real image and virtual image. Real image. So if that light rays are come after reflection and incident on, if the light rays after reflection directly meet, then it will get the real image. And we can see with the eyes as well as we can be captured on a screen. That is called as real image. Virtual image. Virtual image, an image which the outgoing rays from an object do not meet, but they appear to meet by the back extension of the light rays. is called virtual image. And we cannot capture this virtual image on a screen. So real image, the main difference between the real image and virtual image is real image can be captured on a screen and virtual image cannot be captured on a screen. And a plane mirror always forms a virtual image, means we cannot capture on screen. Now, the characteristics of images formed by plane mirror. Let us see, one image is there, one bottle, small pills bottle is there. So let us see an example of pills bottle, image of pills bottle in a mirror. Flat mirror is there, yes. Image formed by mirror are always virtual and erect. Erect means they are in the same direction, and virtual, they cannot be captured on a screen. And size of the image is always equal to the size of the object, and the image is laterally inverted, means left seems to be right side seems to be left side. And the images formed by the plane mirror are as far behind the mirror as the object in front of the mirror, means the distance between the object and the mirror is equal to the distance between the mirror and the image. So the two distances, two heights are equal. Now, lateral inversion. If an object is placed in front of a mirror, then the right side of an object appears to be the left side, and the left side of the object appears to be the right side of this image. This change of sides of an object and its mirror image is called lateral inversion. And types of mirrors. There are mainly two types of mirrors. They are plane mirrors and curved spherical mirrors. They are plane mirrors and spherical mirrors. Plane mirrors are mirrors that have a straight surface, and spherical surfaces are mirrors that have a curved surface. The name itself is telling, no need to get confused. And a saloon mirror is an example for plane mirror, where it is a straight surface. And road safety mirrors and dentist mirrors are the examples for spherical mirrors. If you see them clearly, the surface is just bulged out or bulged in. It is not flat. It is somewhat curved. So hence they are called spherical mirrors. And general life example of this spherical mirrors are simply spoon. If you take a spoon, one side is bulged inside and one side is bulged out. The bulged in is called concave side, bulged out is called convex side. So you can see the image, it is not like the image is not like exactly as the case of plane mirror. They are different. So you may get reverse image, you may get bulged image, you may get enlarged image or a diminished image like that. Spherical mirror. So the reflecting surface of an the reflecting surface of a spherical mirror may be curved inwards or outwards. So spherical mirrors are of two types. They are concave mirror and convex mirror. Concave mirror. In a concave mirror, the reflection of light takes place at the concave surface or bent in surface. Bent in surface is called concave mirror. We see the box, white box there, so that the reflecting surface is bent in surface. So example, car headlight mirrors and dental mirrors, mean dentists use the mirrors to check it. And convex mirror, in a convex mirror, reflection of light takes place at the convex surface or bent out surface. So that is called as convex mirror. Example, security mirrors and side mirrors, rear view mirrors of the car or bike, etc. If you check it, they are not flat, they are simply some bulged out, bent out. Commonly used terms about spherical mirrors. So let you check here, we have two mirrors, spherical mirrors or curved mirrors. So one is bent, these are the reflected surfaces and coated surfaces of two types of mirrors. Now, if you observe clearly, these curved mirrors are simply a part of sphere. That's why the name spherical mirrors came in. Part of sphere. If you check it, it is a part of circle now. Means as we are able to visualize the two dimension only, so it is a part of sphere. When it is cut, it will be our curved mirror. Now, any sphere has a center, so that center for this mirror is called as center of curvature. Center of curvature. So the center of the sphere from which the mirror is obtained is called center of curvature, C. Now, the geometrical center or the midpoint of the mirror is called as pole. The midpoint or geometrical center of the mirror is called pole of the mirror. And the distance between the center of curvature and pole is called radius of curvature. And the axis, imaginary axis passing through the center of curvature and pole is called principal axis. And normal. So an imaginary line that is perpendicular to the surface at a given point. See, as it is a circle, we know at the point of contact, one line is nothing but the tangent. So what is the perpendicular line for the tangent? It is always a radius. So that's why the radius is taken as the normal to the spherical surface. And let us check for concave mirrors. This is concave mirror. Again, it is also a part of circle which contains center. So that is called center of curvature. And the geometrical center of the mirror is called pole, P. And the distance between C and P is called radius of curvature. And same, take a radius over a given point. Okay, draw a line from the center to the given point, that will become the normal at that point. So I hope you understood the common